It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's Maddest Writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1605, recorded Thursday, January 12th, 2017. A one-bit show. It's time for the Giz Wiz, and what stays in Vegas, well, actually doesn't stay in Vegas, because this show is all about what happened at CES last week. We also have another announcement for a new winner of the gadget giveaway, all next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same old show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the only reporter that you can trust on this scene and in the thick of it, Dick DeBartolo. No fake news here on the Giz Wiz.
Just crappy news, really.
How you doing, Dickie D?
No, I'm doing fine. You know, was that our producer went out there too, Josh?
Yep.
Was that Josh's first CES?
Last year we went for a day. It was a very last minute thing. I noticed that flights were like $60 from LA. And they were really cheap from Atlanta, too. So we met up, and we went for a day. So that was his second CES, and it was the last day. And on the last day, like, everyone's gone.
They're gone, yes.
You're like, can I talk to a PR person? And they were like, oh, they left on Saturday. Like, I'm sorry. And so,
and also, the last day isn't even a day, right? Doesn't it end like
Yeah, it's like half
hours?
A day. Yeah, exactly.
Half a day. Yeah,
exactly. So he saw what it was last year, but we couldn't. CES can easily be described as something you can't see in a day, because there are at least four halls. One of them has two stories. I mean, it is so much square footage of space
to see. It's over 3 million square feet.
Of space, 3 million square feet of gadgets and technology and cars and stereos and absolutely everything you can imagine to do with consumer electronics. So he didn't actually get to see it all. So this, even though it was technically not his first CES, it basically was, because he finally got to actually see both levels of South Hall, Central, North. We went over to, I think it's called the West Gate?
Yes, the Sands, at the Sands.
Oh, we went over to the Sands, right.
That's the most fun.
The Sea Space. Did you get to head on over to the Sea Space? Was it the Aria? That area had, it was only open for the first 2 days, and it had companies like Amazon and Uber and Condé Nast and
I avoided that because there was really no gadgets.
Right, exactly. We wanted to go over and see Amazon, and just happened to be there at the same time. They were having a developer mixer. They were like, "Oh, come on in.
Great.
Eat our food. Have our drink."
You said, "Oh, you know, I just brought a couple things here that I wanted to return."
I wonder if I can get a refund. I really need to ask you about this pricing model, because it's weird. We can't figure it out. Right. Exactly. Anyway, it was we had a blast. We did leave after 3 days. But gosh, it was just a lot of fun. It was a ton of fun.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah, yeah, no, this is my, you know, they give away ribbons, not giveaway, but they add ribbons now to your press badge. And I think this is my 26th or 27th CES. And there is one PR lady named Lois Whitman whose badge says all 50 CES shows.
What? Wow.
Yeah. So
wow.
It's not 50 years because early CES used to be twice a year. There used to be a Vegas CES and then a Chicago CES. But at 50. Oh, and I did find my watch, too.
Oh, you did? Yes. I remember.
I went around and asking, and people said, a retrospective of 50 years of I don't know. And then finally, I saw a CES office, and I went in there. And the guy said, oh, it's in, you know, go to the new technology exhibit of innovations. And he said, at the back of innovations, you'll see a very long table marked 50 years of innovations. And I went there and there was my little watch and compliments of Dick DeBartolo. So it was fun.
Yeah, that was really cool. We actually saw that same area, and it was funny because when we walked up to it, there was a security guard, and he had a mission to get everyone through that door. He would point at you, move through this doorway. You, move through the doorway. You, through the doorway. Oh, we're like, wow, there must be something really big going on. And we get in, and no, it was just that little museum. There was no urgency. There was no need. Come on, yeah. Let's go. Let's get in this room. Everybody in.
Very funny. My favorite thing is when you walk out a door, you're the only person walking, and they have huge doors at CES, and you walk out one of them, and then a security guard runs after you and pulls you back and says, no, go out the next door.
Yeah, excuse me. We've been given specific instructions that this door shouldn't be used. This go one out. That's 3 feet away yes. is the only one that you can use to exit this building.
Exactly.
So you walk back into the building and then walk out 3 feet from where you were.
Yes, I know. Anyway, so we have lots of CES stuff. The first gadget, you were the one who said, go see Tracker. And I said, oh, you know, Chad Tracker. They've been doing the same thing year after year. And you said, no, they're doing different stuff. I will take you there. And so here is our co-video.
Of Tracker.
Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz and
Chad Johnson, how are you doing, guys?
Okay, we're at CES, so we're doing a co-interview here. Basically, Chad said if I'm not in it, he's walking off the show. Actually, Chad found this product. It's Tracker. And I said, Chad, Tracker's been around. And he said, but Dick, go over there. They have a lot of new stuff. And Christian, did you invent this?
Yes, I'm one of the founders. Whoa. So my friend and I created the product in college when we almost lost his car to the Pacific Ocean. We went surfing, parked his car on the beach, and when we came back, we saw he parked below the high tide line. We were freaked out because we're about to watch his car get washed away, and we can't find the key anywhere. After ripping the car apart, we're digging around in the sand, and one of our friends says there's a guy with a metal detector. Okay. So the whole goal with Tracker is to take that task of remembering items and move it to our phones. Okay. So if I want to find something, I can use this hot-cold indicator that's on the application, so I know if something's getting colder or if it's getting closer. And then I can just tap a button and then beep that item.
This is right. So and when I talked to you earlier, this is the new Pixel, and I thought I know of your competitor, which is known for being between grout on the floor, and they don't have this feature, which is that it lights up. So if you have something in your bag or in a dark place under the couch.
Well, you know what? Even if you lose your keys, in my living room, I would shut the lights off. So you have two things, sound and light. So it's great.
Yeah, absolutely.
So we came up with a concept when I realized I was putting everything in our pockets, but half of our users don't have pockets. They use purses. So I used my laptop bag like a purse for a week, and then we found out, it's so hard to find things in a bag when you're digging around. Why not just make it light up to find it?
And is the sound level the same or lower on the new one?
So we've made the latest Pixel significantly louder. It's got a bigger battery and longer battery life and better range.
Okay, so we've improved. Longer battery life, you mean?
It's up to a year. But then we also have a free battery replacement program. So,
and it's a user replaceable battery?
Yes, user replaceable batteries.
Which, so if you know the competition, that doesn't happen.
So we see that if we're able to help our users stay active, then everyone can help each other keep track of stuff. Because if I was to, a woman put a tracker in her wallet and had her window smashed in her car, the thief just stole the wallet and took off. And she just came out to shattered glass on her seat. Well, she opened the Tracker app, and she saw a few hours later that the Tracker was located a few blocks away from where her wallet was stolen. She went there. It reconnected over Bluetooth. She beeped it, and she heard her wallet beeping in a ditch. Well, the way that she found it was another tracker user walked by with the app running, and anonymously, confidentially, the app saw her lost item and then uploaded that to the tracker's server, and then it let her know where her item got moved.
Great. And now, when is this available, and what's it going to cost?
So the tracker Pixel is available in spring of 2017 and will be $25.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
See y'all later.
There we go. Sorry. Go ahead. It's funny because there's actually a lot the tracker talked to me about, and it was hard to get it all in one video. I was actually really impressed with them because I've seen their product before. I kind of thought of them as the lower level. We kind of mentioned it in the video. Tile. Tile's been in this space forever. They yes. kind of started this space, and I've always thought of them as kind of a lower level version of that service. But there's a lot of things that I really liked about Tracker above Tile. The light up indicator, so that
that's
you can
great.
Find it.
That's great.
That's awesome. They've partnered with a Wi-Fi manufacturer. It's more of a commercial Wi-Fi manufacturer than, and so it's not like a Linksys or a Cisco, which you would have in your house. But the idea is that if you lose your wallet at a hotel or a convention center or in a lot of cities use this Wi-Fi. In their entire municipal Wi-Fi, that you can find your tracker using those Wi-Fi hotspots. And then finally, they introduced another product which plugs into the house. So you can see a whole bunch of their little products here. But this one right here that plugs into the wall. One issue with the tracker and with Tile is that your phone is the base station, and so if your phone isn't near the tracker, well, you lose all that data. So this idea is that you plug it into the wall, it's always powered, and now you have almost like a base station in your house, so you can set up really smart Internet of Things rules so that if your child comes home and they have a tracker on their backpack, you now know that they've arrived home. Or if you put a tracker on your pet's collar and they get too far away from the house, you now know that your pet just ran away from the house. So there's a lot. Tracker really impressed me with all of the different things that they introduced at CES, and it was really hard to pack it all into that one video.
Well, my biggest thing is that the replaceable battery, because... It seems silly that with
yes.
a tile, you have to, at the end of the year, replace it every year.
Right. Whenever your tile starts to go bad, you get a discount on your next tile, but it is not a user-replaceable battery. And Tracker's gear is all user-replaceable, so the battery goes dead, you just replace the battery. So anyway, yeah, that's another thing. I'm glad you mentioned that. So
yeah. No, and they're about
awesome.
The same price, right? Aren't they both about $25?
Yeah, they're very close. Hey, and you can even get 20% off on New Year's 17 at the top of their website.
Well, there you go. Whoa!
Yeah,
whoa.
So it's Track those, R. Go ahead.
Oh, you know what? Does the Bravo have a light, too?
I think it has an itty-bitty light.
Oh, I see. The new one that he showed us has LEDs all around it.
Right, exactly. Maybe it doesn't have a light. I do know this is newly updated, but the Pixel is the one that has the LEDs designed into the edge of the tracker. And just like Tile, you can click the tracker to access your phone. So if you find your keys, you can find your phone. If you find your phone, you can find your wallet. You know, that sort of thing. But yeah, so Track R, it's spelled a little weird, T-R-A-C-K-R. There's no E in Tracker. And they have a whole bunch of different products. They also introduced a wallet product, which Tile has also had. But you have the Tracker Bravo, a sticker, the Pixel, which we showed off, the Wallet 2.0. This is the Wallet 1.0, an alias, and all that stuff. Also, Tracker works with Alexa, which Tile still doesn't do. So you can ask your Amazon. Sorry if I just it triggered anybody's Echo at home because I said her name. But you can ask your Echo to use Tracker to find your phone, which you can't do with Tile yet. So some really cool stuff. I was really impressed.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
With Tracker and CBS.
Absolutely. Okay, then I found something else. This, I think this is over at Showstoppers, if I'm not mistaken. Something from Four Moms. Four Moms, 3 years in a row, I've done something from them. Last year, it was the self-leveling child seat for the car that also has LEDs that tell you that it's properly locked into the car. And the year before, it was this swing that puts the baby to sleep. Well, this is their new carriage from Four Moms.
Carriages.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads, Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Four Moms, this is the third year we're stopping here because every year they have something really unique. Last year it was the self-leveling baby seat for the car. So you put it in and then all these little devices told you whether it was safely set and level. Well, I'm going by here now and I see, when was the last time you saw a baby carriage with headlights, tail lights, a speedometer, air conditioning, Bluetooth, double clutch? No, all right, so some of that I'm making up. But Amy, once again, is gonna tell us about this new device.
Yeah, so this is our new Four Moms Moxie Stroller.
Moxie Stroller.
Moxie, it has Moxie, yeah.
Okay.
So what we did power on board. So there are actually generators in the wheels, in the back wheels. So as you push the stroller, you're actually generating energy to power the headlights, the taillights, this LCD screen that tells you how fast you're going, how far you're going. You can actually charge your cell phone.
Oh, I was just right going to say, can you charge your cell phone?
Yeah.
This is the control panel here. And so there's a little built-in storage battery that's storing up the power.
Correct, yes, exactly.
That is really great. And can this now disconnect and be used to carry the baby?
Yes.
You can tell I don't have a baby. I carry that thing with the prize.
Yes, it does carry your babies. So it is part of our travel system. So you mentioned the Four Moms self-installing car seat. So you can actually take the carrier out, which we have back here. Do you want me to show it to you here?
Yeah.
So you can just take it out of the car. We have an adapter that you put onto the actual Moxie stroller, and then you can just click it in. Super easy. And then when your baby gets a little bit older, you can put it in the seat. So this actually has three different configurations. So you can use it from infancy all the way up to about 55 pounds. So you can have a bassinet mode, you could have a forward-facing or parent-facing mode as well.
And the retail price?
Retail price is $699.
Now $699 as we see it here.
Right here.
Okay, and in about 3 years, if you only had a version that took something up to about 160 pounds, I would be personally interested. Amy, thank you so much. And you did say it was out now.
It is out now. You can get it at Bye Bye Baby, Amazon, and at 4moms.com.
4moms.com. Dick DeBartolo, Mads, Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
I think 4moms needs to come out with a new product. 4lazy people is their spinoff company. Where, yes, we can have cages and carriages for us adults that are just lazy.
Yes, exactly. And someone said they need a driverless carriage also.
Yeah.
So that you can just send it.
Where are we going to get a self-driving? Right, exactly.
Send it around the block or through the park.
Man, this looks like a very high-tech company that is focused on products for mothers. And wow, what a crazy stroller. I mean, this is like the Rolls-Royce.
I know. Someone is talking about the price. Someone in my neighborhood had this new carriage, and they said, isn't this wonderful? It was just a $990. I said, excuse me?
You spent $1,000 on a baby carriage?
Yes. And I said, oh, you know, this is a Frederic de Mille. I don't know what it was. It was some exotic carriage that evidently...
It's a Neiman Marcus stroller.
Yes, exactly.
This was from Porsche Designs. Wow. It's incredible. Yeah, I mean, I will never, I guess I will, but it's hard to scoff at baby thing prices because I have seen such a range. I mean, we covered that cradle. I've seen now ads everywhere ever since covering that silly cradle that shook the baby
yes,
and had
yes,
a
yes,
sleeve
yes.
for the baby to fit into. Ads everywhere. The Facebook thinks I'm an expecting mob.
The SNOO. S-N-O-O. Yeah, no.
Definitely. I mean, that's another super expensive product. I'm not going to put it past parents to want the absolute best for their children. So it may be expensive, and it may not be the market that I would want. But I'm like, give me a Goodwill stroller. I mean, I'll just
I remember when showing that, I remember the chat room saying, what about duct tape? What are you talking about?
Exactly.
You need this to hold the kid in one place?
Use a good old-fashioned tea towel to swaddle. That's what we did back in my day. Yeah, exactly. But, I mean, gosh, what a fantastic stroller with lights to be visible, charging, and the speedometer. I mean, just everything included, yeah. and very nice clever. Design as well.
And the fact that it interacts with, if you already own the car seat thing, right. That when the kid is too old for a stroller, then you take the car thing, and that becomes, so I believe she said it's anywhere from like 3 months to when they become 55 pounds or over.
Right.
So the carriage can have a very long life in your house.
Right. I mean, you can see it's kind of switching between modes from lay down to the car seat to
that's my first
position.
Class seat right yeah. there. There,
there
it is.
Goes.
There it is.
Oh, my God. They fixed it, and they put it on the four mom stroller. That's why you had
that's
to sit coach.
That's where my seat went. That's where my seat went.
So at four moms with the numeral four, MOMS.com,
formoms.com. And our final guy is every year, and this year was no exception, there are more and more toy companies going to CES to get a jump on Toy Fair. And I found this is kind of a fun gadget, so let's take a peek.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're at Fisher Price. This is the Smart Cycle, and I'm going to read you something here. It says, think and learn, Smart Cycle. The more kids pedal, the more they can learn. And this young lady is actually pedaling toward a college education. About how long do you... No, so tell me how this works.
Smart Cycle is great. It's basically combining a physical gaming experience with a really fun learning adventure in a great way. So kids can be in control of their learning by using these handlebars, as I'm doing right now. There's these action buttons. You can make your guy jump and also interact with the content. There's this joystick action to interact with the mini games. And then, of course, the pedaling action. So the faster I pedal, the faster my car goes. And I can also pedal backwards if I want them to go backwards.
Now, are there different games and different learning levels?
Yes. So the app automatically levels throughout. The app that comes with the bike is free, and the focus for curriculum is on literacy. Within the app, there's driving, gaming, and racing. So right now I'm driving and collecting letters as I go. There's mini games that help to reinforce the literacy curriculum, such as rhyming and syllables and phonics. And
all the time you're exercising.
Yes. Absolutely, and the racing's just fun. You're just being active and pedaling as fast as you can.
All right, Michael, get a shot of this dashboard over here. So when is this coming out?
So this comes out in fall 17, so consumers can expect to see it in stores starting in June.
And the price will be? The price will be?
The price is $149.99. It comes with the free app, as I mentioned, and then there are three additional apps available featuring favorite Nickelodeon characters for $4.99 each.
That's great. You know, unfortunately, she just stopped pedaling and has been expelled. What a sad way to end this spot. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Thank you so much. Okay, bye.
Interesting. So it's, you know, the first thing you think of is one of those cycles that you see at the gym, you know. You're going to start... You're going to start a cycling class with the 6-year-olds. Very, very interesting. That it looks like that demo that she had was human size and is not exactly what the product looks like. Because on their website, they have that, you know, just like this console doesn't look exactly the same.
Oh, no, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely that was probably, yeah, because I asked if I could sit on one and they said no.
Right.
So yeah. I assume that the one that she was sitting on was made for a person like herself and not the kids' version.
Right. It looks like it plugs in.
I think it's a clever idea.
Yeah. And it looks like it plugs in with the normal, very old now, RCA.
Yes, the RCA jacks.
Exactly.
Yes, exactly.
So your TV has to have that available to it. But I really like this because it is kind of, I mean, I know a lot of parents, they find it very hard to let their kids just go outside and roam around. Or they don't have they're not in a neighborhood where they can do that. Or even if they are, it's still scary to just say, go, you know, get out of here and play in the outside world where, who knows what'll happen. So, having an option to stay inside the house or around the house and get exercise while also kind of scratching that gaming itch, I think this is fantastic. I really like it. Yeah, go
and
play
learning,
in traffic.
And learning. And driving
learning.
Down an alphabet road. And then they're adding, you know, she said Nickelodeon thinks that there's going to be a Dumb Dora game and a SpongeBob game and Hot Wheels and Barbie.
Yeah.
And I think she said the games are $5, so that's pretty good.
Yeah. I also feel like the price isn't too bad. It was over $100, but I've also seen plenty of Hot Wheels or other things, you know, of that nature, you know, this type of riding game be more expensive, be exactly in that price range. So I think the price isn't too bad either. So,
yeah.
I find it very interesting, the Fisher-Price Smart Cycle. So kids get some exercise, some gaming, and learning all combined into one. I need one for me. That's all I'm saying. I need the physics app and the chemistry app, and then we're good to go.
Yeah, I think so. I think so. We also need the Chad's crappy corner app.
You're right, we do. Here we go.
Chad's crappy corner.
Get it. Okay, so on today's crappy corner, we are still in the month of things my parents gave me for Christmas that
were supposed
to be on the Giz Wiz. And we'll get to our giveaway, our Patreon giveaway, near the end of the episode when we thank our patrons. So today's gadget I'm very, very excited about, and I hope it falls into the category of less crappy than more crappy.
Okay.
It is called the Toy Driver. The Toy Driver. So you've heard of a screwdriver? Well,
yeah.
This is basically a power screwdriver for your toys. You have heard me complain over and over and over again on this show that I hate those tiny little screws that come in gadgets. Those screws that are inhumanly small to make sure that they don't have to put the warning that there's a choking hazard on it because only adults can open up screws.
You can't change the batteries without taking the screws
exactly.
out.
Yeah, exactly. Those are the bane of my existence. So hopefully the Toy Driver will help me in that regard. So first, let's go ahead and open her up. It looks pretty simple. It has some instructions. Now, one interesting thing is if you look at the blister pack, and I don't know about this, you can see that there is the Toy Driver, and there's also this little bit right here. And I feel like it probably came with an extra bit.
Oh, yeah.
At some point in its life. But, it should have come with an extra bit. This is only the flathead. I don't have a Phillips.
Oh, there must have been because I think all the battery compartments are Phillips.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Well, I think we're getting a good picture of what your family thinks of you, Chad.
Yeah, exactly. What? I am so confused. Okay. Okay, so hey, well, that's interesting. This is weird. So it comes with batteries. These batteries.
Is that a compartment? Is that a compartment to store the other bit in?
It looks like it. It looks like this opens, slides open, and there's a compartment for extra.
Oh, for the other.
For the extra other bits. Bit. Oh, no! What a dud!
Oh, no!
I hope that this Okay, well, so I'm impressed that it comes with batteries.
Yeah.
Not impressed.
Do the batteries weigh like nothing?
Oh yeah, they're super light. Yeah. Super that light batteries. yeah, exactly. So
testing batteries.
Exactly. Yeah. Accessory batteries. Okay, so let's break those open and slide these in. And let's close this up and lock it in place. There we go. And let's see if it turns on.
Well, I guess it doesn't matter that you don't have the other bit. Polarity of the batteries.
I didn't think I had to read the instructions.
What did you say about that this was not going to be a crappy gadget? That this is going to be...
I really wanted this to be a good gadget. Let me just make sure that I put the batteries in correctly.
Now, it's not entirely... impossible that the batteries are actually dead.
You are absolutely right. Okay, so let's try one more time. I'm gonna just make sure that I put the batteries in correctly. And there we go.
Okay.
Okay. I got some extra batteries. Here we go. Okay. These should be brand new.
Do you have an extra Phillips head bit for a device like that?
I have neglected to get the extra Phillips heads.
Someone in the chat room says, chat room hands Chad an extra screwdriver.
It doesn't work. okay.
Oh, well, wait a minute.
What?
Oh, I was going to say, maybe it is just a toy screwdriver.
Maybe. Okay, so this, it looks like this depresses in. I thought at first it slid forward, but it definitely doesn't do that. Looks like you just push it. This doesn't make any sense to me, because how also would you take battery... Okay, so you must push on one side and the other side to get it to...
Well, you know, my guess is maybe it's a safety thing. You have to have your finger on it the whole time you're screwing.
Yeah, no, unscrewing. I agree with that. And I was really wondering how does it know if it goes in versus out?
Oh, I see. Okay.
There are zero instructions other than what's on this. Okay, let me do one more thing. The only thing is, I've been assuming that the negative side, which is the flat side, goes on the springs, and that the positive side goes on the.
Usually
that's
correct.
The case. I don't see any. Orientation instructions, so I'm just going to flip them backwards and see if something...
Yeah, do that. That's a good way to do it.
Okay. Nope. I think this is the crappiest gadget we have ever talked about on the show. Yeah.
Did you find it online? Because the reviews might give us a clue.
Yeah, we did find it online. It's on Amazon. Let's see what
they say.
And
maybe the picture, chat. They have a picture of the product. It'll show
here it
the
is.
Packaging.
Okay, so this is the toy driver. It has 52 reviews, and it's at 3 stars. It the photo comes with extra bits. I didn't get
okay.
those. You store them in
the compartment. Oh, and they store in the... Okay.
Okay. No, 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 no. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so it looks like he's pushing that forward, right? I mean, I'm just guessing.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think it's forward back.
Position.
Yeah, forward and reverse functions.
Okay, let's try this one last time, although I do not have much hope here.
No.
Okay. Oh, we got to lock it in place once we... Push it, lock it. Okay, push forward. No. Oh!
I heard something.
I heard something too. How on earth are you supposed to interact with this thing? I'm pushing it forward. No. What? How does this work? Forward and reverse functions. To tighten and loosen small screws, low torque power for small screws.
Low to zero torque.
can't figure out how I got it to move. Okay, so I'm just walking you through my process here, right? So this is the only button we got. Really, there's no mechanical way that it can slide forward. It's just not possible for it to slide forward here, okay? It's not possible for it to slide backwards here. It's still not moving.
Oh, my word.
If I push in, there we go. We got the top. That takes a lot of force.
So there's definitely something wrong with it.
What? Now I can't get it to work. I don't know how this thing works. I'm using both hands to push this. There we go.
What was making it? Is it when you push up on the battery compartment? Is that what's making it go?
You know what? That might be it. If I keep my hand on the battery compartment. You're right. You're right.
Yeah, it's a loose battery compartment.
Okay.
Yeah.
This may actually be fixable. If we take this spring
and bend the springs
pull
up a
it,
little.
And pull it yep. towards us. There we go.
This is like Twit's know-how. You don't even have to go over to Twit.
I can't this believe
know-how
this.
Know-how for children.
Oh my gosh. Okay. So there's that. Let's try this one more time.
Okay. Does it say in the package that you need two very strong men to operate it?
It should say on the package you need tape to keep the bottom of this. Okay, so we got a thing of tape. You know what? Okay, here we go. Let's tape the bottom of this.
Captain J said, why did you get a screwdriver and take it apart?
That's what you need. Okay, so two pieces of scotch tape pressed as firmly to the bottom as possible. It still doesn't work.
No,
you need to put a hand.
Duct tape. You need power to push that battery compartment up.
Okay, well, we've at least got it functioning. I have a few gadgets here, and not one of them has a flat head on it for me to remove. So let's start with this. Is the we've seen this a few times. The paper airplane.
The paper
launcher
flyer thing.
Oops, sorry about that. This has not a version for the Phillips head. This is only, a flat head. This is a Phillips head. So it doesn't even fit inside of the. Of the plastic enclosure. It doesn't even fit inside. Come on, camera, we can focus here. That's pretty frustrating. Camera, come on. There we go. That camera really does want to focus on the floor there. But this is okay. I give this a 5 out of 5 crappiness rating. There is
And it's $10.
Yeah. Yeah, $9.89 for the toy driver. It doesn't fit inside that enclosure. Okay, this enclosure, it fits inside. Okay, this is the Collins crossword solver. I'll have to use it in a configuration where I can press my thumb onto the battery compartment.
Okay.
There we go. And then use my pinky. Oh, look at that. It was just that easy, folks. In 5 simple steps, remove the batteries, cut open the batteries, put the batteries in, take the batteries out, put the batteries in, use your thumb to cover up the thing. And finally, the Collins crossword puzzle solver battery compartment is opened. Let's see how easy it is to put it back together here.
Wow.
This is like a
real workshop.
We haven't had this crappy of a gadget in a long time, Biggie. It looks like there is some magnetic.
Beatmaster's waiting for the I fix it score.
I give up. Okay. You know what's so much simpler? Go to Target, buy one of these sets. They're super simple. And just do it manually. Luckily, they do have the correct size heads. You set that right on there. You set it inside of the gadget. and you're good to go.
And how much was that set? Any idea from Target?
$5 at most. $5. Okay, we're done. Okay.
All right.
That is the crappy gadget for this week. The toy driver, low torque battery operated screwdriver tool for small screws.
Did you say low or no torque?
It doesn't really matter. If you can get yours to work, congratulations. You can get it on Amazon for $10. Although we at Giz Wiz do not suggest it. Sometimes they're crappy, which is good. That about wraps up for this episode of the Crappy Corner. Let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Fog of Horn. Okay,
and
what do you got for us this week?
On this week's Gadget Warehouse, a couple weeks ago I said we were adding another category. How about people who bought something on Kickstarter or Indiegogo? Why not make a video and tell us how it worked for you? And we did get a video from Dave Martell.
Oops,
I'm
sorry
submitting.
About that. That was my fault. There we go.
That's okay. I'm submitting a video of a product I got on Indiegogo, DeZeus Car Charger and Car Locator. Here is my YouTube video.
Okay. Now. Here we go. And it has the logo of what it is.
Oh, okay. At the beginning.
Hi, Dick and Chad. My name is Dave, and I love your show. A while back, you asked if anyone purchased an item on one of the FundMe sites. Well, I purchased this item on Indiegogo. The retail price was estimated to be $49.95, and I could buy one for $29.95. Here's the item. It's really a multifunction car charger. You plug this into your cigarette lighter in your car. It can charge two USB devices at once and can charge them twice as fast as a normal charger, but it doesn't stop there. When you shut off your car, it sends the GPS coordinates of your location to your smartphone so you can easily find your car when you return. I'll show you the app. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to have the camera focus on my smartphone, so I ended up taking some screenshots to talk to you about it. This first screenshot is I parked my car, and the app is telling me I'm 1,200 feet away, and the arrow is pointing towards the car in the northeast direction. Secondly, if I pull down the map at the bottom, it'll actually show me a Google map of where the actual car is. Another nice feature of this unit is whenever you turn your car off, it starts a timer for you so you know how long you've left your car there. And on the left hand side you can see that it'll set an alarm for you if you need to go put some money back in the parking meter, etc. So it's a real handy thing to know how long you've parked there, and you can actually have an alarm come up when the time is up on your parking meter. The third and fourth slides are new functions. They're available on the new unit. This one, as the gives you your car battery monitor, so it'll monitor the car battery for you. And last but not least, you have two of the brand new reversible USB ports, so you can plug in a USB cable either way, which makes it real handy. That's about it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and I hope everybody has a happy new year.
All right.
Nice.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, Dave Martell. And it's still selling for $29 on Amazon. And, you know, someone in the chat room asked an interesting question. Do all new cars still have cigarette lighters? I assume they do.
Yeah.
Only because there are so many gadgets that use them.
Yeah. I think it's now just become, it's the car's power plug. You know, the car, okay. A car is going to not have a normal plug. It's going to have a cigarette lighter. Gadgets for the car are going to need a cigarette lighter, basically. Right. But yeah.
So, Dave, thank you for your video, and thank you for being the first one to send in a video of something that you got on one of the Fund Me sites. And you'll get a February Mad, one of those 30 to 35-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. And we are looking for more videos. I think we have maybe one more left, but I'm not even sure about that. A video, the Gadget Warehouse thing has turned into pretty much anything that our viewers want to send us. 2 to 3 minutes long, I invented this. I bought this gadget. I bought this gadget and it's terrible. I bought this gadget and I love it. Or one of our favorites, something that you've had sitting around in a drawer or in the garage that you just can't throw away. And it was interesting, I thought, at CES, I was talking at my old Beepware watch from 25 years ago was on display at CES. Even with five arenas of gadgets, there was quite a crowd at this 50 years of technology. It was fun seeing the first VCR that was $1,200 and didn't even have a clock.
Yeah.
You kind of had to be there to record the show and change tapes if it was more than an hour. So people love new technology, but they love old technology too. So if you have an old gadget somewhere, a video, 2 to 3 minutes, put it on YouTube, click unlisted, and that way only people with the link can see it. Send us that link, and send that link to mail@gizwiz.tv, and we send the mad and the picture if you live in the U.S. or Canada. If you live outside of that, send us a little note you want us to read or a shout out to whoever you like, and we'll do that as your prize. Mail@gizwiz.tv.
And that's perfect. With that, let's move on to the letter, which may still or may not be Christmas theme. Here we go. Oh, it's not. Time for the letters.
Our letter is from Marden12, M-A-R-D-E-N, who is praising something she saw on the show. It's not a video, just a letter. The subject is the folding lamp, and Marden writes, I saw the OR key folding lamp on the Giz Wiz. I cannot stress enough how great I think it is. I am relegated to a dark corner of the house with poor lighting, and not being a touch typist, I have to see the keyboard. The lamp is a boom. It's very compact, bright, and stylish. Once again, I thank you, sir. Marden 12. This thing is really great. I love it too. Actually, a friend came over and I thought, I didn't buy this guy a gift. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to give away my lamp and just buy another one. So it is folds in every direction. It's $25. It runs off USB, but the built-in battery, I think it was 5 to 6 hours. It's really beautifully done, all made out of aluminum.
Yeah.
And it's still on Amazon. And, you know, you're talking about prices. I don't know why I didn't jump on it last night. Last night, for about 2 hours, it was $21.99. So I totally don't understand.
I've figured out how. I finally, over a long time, I have finally figured out why Amazon fluctuates their prices so much. This should have been in a tease. I should have teased this at the beginning. Well, finally divulge why Amazon's prices fluctuate so much, and here's why. Amazon does this thing where normal people, can sell their products, and normally businesses sell their products on Amazon. So you always see this Amazon page, and this right here is called the buy box. It's where you buy it right now and add it to your cart. But you can see that there's this, on this product, there's only one new. That means that this manufacturer basically has this product. And on a lot of products, so let's just jump over to Amazon and find some random product. Here are the light up glasses, right?
Yeah, which are great also.
Okay, right? Perfect. Now, okay, this is another bad example because there's only one person who is selling this product. What we're looking for is a product where a lot of people sell it, where it's a very, very generic product that basically anyone can get a hold of. So let's go back to Amazon and see if we can find some generic product. We could do the toothpick holder. We could do basically anything here. You can see that there's also the lights,
because I think lots of people sell those strip lights.
There we go. Only one new here. We got to find a product where lots of people are selling this. Here we go. We got new and used. So you can see here that the one that's in the buy box is the $7.98. This is fulfillment by Amazon, but the seller information isn't Amazon. It doesn't say this is Amazon. It says this is Zi Trades. And the person underneath is GTM Stores. Now, this person's selling a used version of it, but a lot of times, if you come into a popular product, you'll see that multiple people are selling this product and doing fulfillment by Amazon, even though the seller information isn't Amazon. So what happens is these businesses get these products, either wholesale or by some other means, and then they can sell the product on Amazon. And what Amazon does is they charge a base fee for, see, this is a great one. There's 51 people, new and used, all sorts of people. This is an actual Amazon. This is actual Amazon sourcing this product. But you can see this product right here is Prime. It costs a dollar more, so you're not going to buy it from there. Amazon's going to show you the cheapest one. But it's this toy shop, which is a business. And what happens is...
So when someone buys the $8.59 one, is the price going to immediately jump to the next lowest price?
It may if they only have, say, 5 in stock. If they run out of stock, it's going to jump over to this person, this toy shop, because they're the next lowest Prime available. Okay. Now, and this is very interesting because the toy shop can set their own price. What happens is Amazon does, it's basically a flat fee to process, to give that fulfilled by Amazon sticker. That costs the toy shop about $5 to $7. It costs them to have that Prime shipping available, but Amazon handles all of that. So they have to have gotten a hold of that product at such a low price that they're still going to be able to make a profit off of it after that $5 to $7 fee. So there's not a lot of people that are going to be doing that fulfilled by Amazon Prime
Shipping. Do they actually send the products to Amazon so that they're in the Amazon warehouse?
Exactly. And so that's why you'll also see on a lot of products it says, well, it's Prime, we're going to get a restocking on January 15th, and so we know it's already shipped. We can see the shipping details. It's coming to our warehouse. It's going to be back in stock, and it'll stay in stock from toy shop, from some other place. And this also allows Amazon to have an unlimited shelf space of products, because if the toy shop wants to research and develop their own toy product, they can now list it on Amazon for whatever price they want, and they don't have to go through, they don't have to have a brick and mortar store, they don't have to do any of that. So anyway, it's a very interesting system. That the fulfillment by Amazon, that Prime, that all of us customers really badly want,
is
a service charge that they charge to the company that is listing the product. So that product has to be lower in cost to that company. They had to wholesale it for a much cheaper price in order for it to be listed as Prime. But that is why the price fluctuates so much, because there might be 17 companies, if it's a super popular product that sells 1,000 of them a month, there might be several companies competing on that specific product. It's very complicated, but also very interesting that Amazon is able to pull off that price snatching.
Yes. Well, that was like that bug bulb that Kitron hated. I bought the bug bulb too, and the woman, you know, they were recalled, and she said, "What's the serial number?" Or I forgot what she wanted, and she said, "Oh, we didn't ship that one." She said, "There are many companies shipping that exact same bulb."
Right. And it also makes sense as to why sometimes you look at a product and you go, well, how did Amazon think that this was okay? You know, a lot of times I blame Amazon for a lot of mishaps with products, with the quality, this is listed on Amazon. Can you believe that it went through Amazon sensors and it's here? They're not really doing that. It's a lot more. It's almost more like eBay than I ever thought it was.
Oh, that's interesting.
So yeah. So it's a very, very, very interesting setup that they have. Anyway, that's basically it.
And I'll tell you one other thing. Did you ever see the 60 Minutes piece on Amazon warehouses?
I think I saw part of it. I don't remember what.
Oh, okay. So the thing was, they were walking down the aisle and someone said, "Why are there books here? And right above the books, there are ceramic ashtrays."
Right.
What? Right. What's your organization? And the guy said they had a computer go into the warehouse and figure out every square inch of space and where everything, it was like Tetris.
Right.
So he said when this computer got done organizing everything, they got 40% more stuff in the same warehouse.
Right.
Because everything fit in the available space, and the robots who run around getting the stuff know where everything is. It doesn't matter. The ashtrays are in books.
Right.
So I'm thinking, what an amazing thing.
Exactly. And then on top of that, Amazon still does a lot of robots where the robot will pick up the whole shelf and they'll bring the shelf to a human, which will then have to pick the product. It's, you know, picking and shipping. And it actually is advantageous for them not to have the same products next to each other. Because if you're looking for a book and you've been given an entire shelf of books, well, now you're looking for that specific book. But if you're given a shelf and there's, you know, toilet plungers and toothpick birds and all sorts of random stuff, and there's only three books on the shelf, you go, "That's not it. That's not it. Well, that's it. There you go." And so it works out for the pickers that they come to a shelf, or a shelf comes to them, and they can quickly find a product because there's only really one of that product on that shelf. This is what Amazon does in order to stay competitive and to have the lowest price, you know, available. It's just all this amazing technology.
And our audience, we are training our audience. Any one of you can now go work for Amazon.
Exactly.
You just graduated from Amazon U. But if you do get a job there and anybody orders the toy screwdriver, say it's out of stock.
Yeah, please. Just discontinue product if you could.
Do them a favor.
Do everyone a favor. we've come to the show, part of our show where we like to thank our Patreons. Our Patreons make this show happen every single week. Thank you so much. Patreon is a place where you can support independent content creators like the Giz Wiz. And we have our setup to support us every show that we do. We have over 290 patrons. Big, big thank you. Now, normally our patrons choose what my Crappy Corner theme is this week or this month. And this month, because I had all these gadgets for my family, we're doing something else to give back. We're giving a gadget that we used to have, that we've previously shown on the show to one of our patrons. And this week's gadget is the Car and Driver Approved Selections Vacuum Cleaner. We were just talking about the cigarette lighter.
Oh, yes,
this plugs into your cigarette lighter.
Right.
We reviewed it on the show and we actually liked it. We were actually pretty impressed with the suction available from it, and it did a pretty good job. Very small, compact, pretty nice. We actually ended up really, really liking it. That was a surprise on the show. The lucky winner of this gadget is Jeffrey Maddox. Jeffrey Maddox, thank you so much for being a patron. Thank you so much for supporting the show. And you will be receiving the Car and Driver Approved Selections Vacuum Cleaner.
Wow.
From the warehouse, from my warehouse.
And you know, if you do this same theme next January, gifts from my family, I would get a different family to give you stuff. Just
so far.
Just for the January show.
I need to save the batteries out of here because I think that's the most important part of of this gadget right now, is the most expensive part. So the toy driver was not so good. Don't forget to play What the Heck Is It at gizwiz.biz. Not only does gizwiz.biz have show notes from our show talking about every gadget that we talked about, it, including links from the letter and the warehouse, but you can also play What the Heck Is It on the sidebar. And this is what we're trying to figure out. What the heck it is. That gadget is obviously, what's that painting that does all the different staircases and different levels?
Chat room, anybody know? Maybe Dennis will run down. I know who you mean, but I don't know.
Exactly. Nothing. Oh, this is a 3D model, a 3D representation of that. You can see the steps are all weird, and it's more of an art piece than a gadget. But if you know what this gadget is, M.C. Escher, that's what I was thinking. A few people are saying
we have a smart chat room.
I know, we do. Smarter than the hosts. They're going to take over one day. There's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers, if you know what this gadget is. 24 Double the Mad Magazines for funny, hilarious, cute, and clever answers. So get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. We are live. We record this show live, and we're going to be at the same time slot for a very long time, for a few months now. So keep it in your head that every Thursday at around 4:30 Pacific time or 7:30 Eastern time, Central and Mountain time, you're going to have to do the conversion yourself, is when we are live. And the only URL you need to remember is gizwiz.tv. Like a television station, gizwiz.tv. And we'll be live every Thursday around 4:30 to 7:30. 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. And if you missed the show, you can head on over to gizwiz.tv and check out the show notes, download past episodes, and see all of the gadgets that we talked about. Of course, subscribe on iTunes or YouTube to make sure it's delivered to you. That about wraps it up for this episode of the Giz Wiz. See you next time!
I'll be here!